Hi everybody, and welcome to another episode of Unboxed, Watched, and Reviewed. Today we're doing my kind of movie. So, what's the movie? Well, let's take a look back and find out. Final Flesh. Never heard of it. Now this looks strange. It's an atomic bomb that looks like a face with what looks like Night Train to Terror tracks flying out of them. And then on the back we have this crazy scribbling. See it with your mind. It's a movie, open box to watch, custom made porn prank, arrow dollar sign, bone wet video. And then of course you have this little creature saying, prefer. This came highly recommended to me by a girl on Facebook. She said it is fucked up and that I gotta see it. The first film to unleash the truth of the flesh psyche. The fuck is a flesh psyche? Pornsploitation. Pornsploitation. Sounds like fun. I can't tell you what pornsploitation means, but I like the sound of it. And we have a quote. This movie creamed my demon, says Matthew 3:18. So this tells me nothing about what this movie is. So let's find out, shall we? You guys ready to watch Final Flesh? I know I am. I got it open. All we gotta do is put it in the PlayStation pouch. Oh, what's this? Drugs? What the fuck? Look at this shit. This came out of it. It's not drugs. Final Flesh, antibacterial hand gel. Alright, you guys ready to cream your demon? Play. Oh my god. Well, already this is not what I expected. It begins with the black family sitting at a table, and the daughter said, I think there's a bomb about to hit.
Mom and Dad, I'm scared. We have to get out of here.
This is all very homemade and terribly acted and just wonderful.
Dad, I hate you.
The mom says, I had this really weird dream, and in it, I couldn't get the bathroom faucet on. So I showered with
tears of neglected children.
What in the fuck? There's another jar. Angel blood. This woman is just showering in tears and angel blood, and it's homemade. Homemade. Oh no. There's another jar. Tears of corrupt politicians. And there's not water in that one, it's a little mouse. The dad got up and walked away and the daughter was like, excuse me, I'm gonna go powder my nose and take a dump. So the daughter goes into the bathroom and I was just floored by her acting. She is one of the worst that I've seen since starting this show. She's so bad she makes Robin Griggs look like a Golden Globe nominee.
Have you ever wondered what it would feel like to be stabbed to death?
Bit dramatic.
She comes out of the bathroom proclaiming that she stunk it up and she sits back down at the table.
The
dad was reading something and now he put the paper down and he's got a mustache. And he said, we're gonna take a vote. All in favor, raise your hand. And nobody does. All opposed, and they both raise their hands. What they're voting on, I have no idea. He just says, let's vote. And they do.
And he's going to each one smelling their armpits.
What in the fuck is this? I had no idea this was going to be a comedy. He really gets his head deep into the daughters. Pam!
He's got his face in her armpit and she said, can I open my eyes now? And he's just in her armpit.
He sits back down and says the results of the vote are in. It's a tie. And then something alarms Pam.
Oh my god, there's something going on in my panties.
The girl said, there's something going on in my panties. And she reached in and took out an egg. She said, I just laid an egg. And then the mom walked over and gave her a hug and looked at the egg. And now something's happening to her.
What?
And she just, laid a cantaloupe and started licking it all over the place. And the daughter ran over to it. And they're both licking the cantaloupe at the same time that just came out of the mom's vagina.
This is my territory.
Oh no, now the daughter is shitting something out, and she just shit out a huge steak. She shit out a big steak. The mom said, "You look so hungry." And the daughter said, "Okay, here you go, Mr. Peterson." And she's holding the steak up to her tit.
While breastfeeding her newborn steak, she says, "Oh God, I'm gonna be sick."
Why is she gonna throw up?
The mom takes out a can of Hormel and says,
"Oh, what about this can of chili? Oh yeah, yeah, open it up and scoop it out so I can puke in there."
The dad tells her that she's not puking into that can until she's eaten everything out of it.
Eat it all up.
Ew! It's disgusting.
Get it all up in you.
All good.
Okay, that's good. Now throw up.
These people are great.
So she pukes into the can, and when she's finished, there's still room to spare.
It's only half full. Anyone else needs to go?
Me, I gotta pee.
Can you believe this? Oh, the can's only half full. I'll give it to me. I gotta pee.
This is so good. The dad just walked into the other room and died. So the dad has passed out and the daughter said, "Good, we're gonna teach him a lesson. Get the bib and the diaper." This daughter is saying, "We'll wake him up and we'll convince him he's a baby. We treat him like a baby, he'll be a baby." And cut to the mom in the bathroom, sitting pantyless on the toilet. Oh! Oh, wow! Oh, the mom just spread her legs and then wiped her pissy pussy and looked right at the camera, and it was explicit.
After pissing out actual pee instead of eggs, she goes back to the dining room to fuck with the father.
And now they're feeding the dad, who's on the ground in a bib. They're trying to feed him the chili. Oh no, she said, "Do you ever have fantasies about going back into the womb?" And he said, "Can I, Mom?" And the mom stood up and said, "Sure." And she dropped her jeans. She's not wearing panties. And the dad is going up to it. And the mom's pushing his head, trying to
stuff his head into her vulva.
He said, "Let me try this side." The mom said, "Wait a minute, let me get some butter." The daughter just walked in. "Mommy, why did you want to kill the president?" She's got the steak up to her tit with a little towel around it.
"Mommy, why did you want to kill and murder the president?"
This is so weird.
Still dressed as a baby, the dad says, "There's something I've been meaning to tell you all. I'm actually a woman." And the mom says, "Well, I'm actually a man." And then the dad replies, "Me too." And then they all kiss.
The family is now kissing in one huddle, all kissing each other at once. And now it's another family waking up at their table. It's a white family. They're waking up and looking around. And right before this was a quick shot of an atomic bomb going off.
So the black family was killed by the bomb, and now they're this white family who are living in purgatory, sitting around their dining room table.
Now the dad in his bathroom, on a phone, sitting on a toilet, and he's saying, "I'm blonde, I'm blonde, I'm blonde, I'm blonde, I'm blonde, I'm blonde, I'm blonde."
This movie is very Giuseppe Andrews, very John Waters, and very Rince Dream, director of Cafe Flesh and Dr. Caligari. Anyway, back at the table, they're all sitting around, and the dad says,
"God, make yourself known. Show yourself."
God speaks to them via notes under the door.
"It's from God. He's hungry."
It's another note being passed under. It says, "You are in my womb."
"We're all trapped in his womb."
They said, "We can get out of here if God can puke us up." And then USA.
People sitting on toilets is a motif in this movie, and it happens quite frequently.
Now the daughter is shitting on a toilet, eating a muffin. She said, "I pushed too hard."
She pushes so hard that she literally shits her brain out.
She just flushed the brain down the toilet. This is really good. So far, you guys have got to see this.
There's so much weird shit going on in this movie that I can't even explain half of it. Because literally,
every line in this is fucked up. There has not been a single normal part. And it's only been on for 23 minutes. And it's 1:09.
A while later, we see the mom standing there holding a knife up to her neck, and
the dad is totally wrapped up in a white sheet. And he's saying he's dying in his deathbed. The mom sat down and said, "That's right, you'll be dead within 1 minute." And she took off her cardigan thing. She says, "I've been cheating on you with this guy." And she puts on a big skeleton mask. And the husband says to his wife, who's in a mask, "I just want to watch you bang her, hard style." Whoever wrote this, I really like. After the daughter eats her father's hot dog dick and does a strip tease for God, and now all three of them are embracing, it's probably gonna go on to the next family, which it just did. Here we have a dad and two girls who are obviously in the porno business. It's like palindromes, it's the same people switching bodies or something. They're saying weird shit. The dad said, "I've had it up to here with consciousness." And he took this little wall clock off the wall and put it into the fridge. Everyone in this movie is poetic and perverted, sort of like the Punane poets. You guys remember the Punane poets? How could you forget with a name like Punane poets? It's like the vagina monologues in the hood, talking about their vaginal hoods. You know, pussies have hoods. The slutty mom grabs the slutty daughter's thumb and she's a total porn star. In the bedroom, the mom says, "I'm a bird with birth defects." And the dad says, "Well, at least you don't have three dicks."
"You only have one."
"Oh yeah, I guess I do only have one. Oh well." And he takes out his very real and very hard penis. Now he's jacking off from a side view. It's just explicit as shit. I don't know why I was so surprised to see X-rated scenes in this. I mean, the movie is considered pornsploitation.
"I bet you can't give birth doggy style."
She said that to a mouse in a jar, and then it just turned into a steak. They're shaking the jar of steak. Suddenly it's become her kids. They're just shaking this Tupperware jar with a steak in it. The daughter's hand, whose name is Miss Pearl, starts to strangle the father. So the mom wrapped a garbage bag around Miss Pearl's head and taped it real tightly.
"I've got an idea. I can feel it kicking in my head like a baby."
So to take care of this problem, they amputate her hand. I mean, this dialogue is so weird and poetic that it's sort of like Dr. Caligari meets Where the Dead Go to Die. It's a whole bunch of good movies all rolled into one. Moving on, we get some really cummy humor, a turkey baster called Grandfather, and lots of insertion. Oh my god. The girl said, "I need to erase that Bible baby inside of me." And she took a pencil and just stuck it in. And it's a close-up and she's just fucking herself with this eraser from a pencil. See, I say something and then I look at it and it's just like, oh, what's this now? She's sucking a condom filled with ketchup.
"Mommy, where did I come from?"
"Daddy fucked you out."
After a ton of really crazy and weird fucked up shit, the family finally huddles around and it just showed each family member. And now three people are waking up. I love the idea of this movie. Families transforming into other families, all waking up at their dining room tables. To me, it's just really cool. The family before his table was covered in sticks. Now this one's covered in leaves. Just like everything prior to this, this family is just as unusual. She just pulled a cherry out of the girl's twat and said, "I found you, cherry. My innocence is back." She put it into her own female slot. We get more and more weird stuff that I'm gonna leave out of this review because I want you to see it for yourself.
"Here's you."
That was very Dr. Caligari, the way she came in. The family huddled together, and now it's back with the black family. It's just repeating what happened in the beginning. The best part. After retracing our footsteps through everything we saw in the beginning, the movie ends. So that was Final Flesh. I had no idea what this was going into it, and I have no idea what it was coming out of it. All I knew is that I really, really enjoyed it. What a weird fucking movie. So what do I give Final Flesh on a scale of 1 to 5? Well, I'd have to give it a 5. I love movies like this, and there aren't enough of them. I was delightfully surprised. As soon as it started, I was like, okay, what? I loved this. And if you like homemade movies that just don't make any sense and are fucked up and really perverted, check this out. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time.